Air standard efficiency of this Brayton cycle can be calculated, or expression is derived for the air standard efficiency of the Brayton cycle on the basis of some assumptions. These assumptions are, first is all the processes are internally reversible, civil, that is, there is no frictional losses, that is, no friction. Okay. Another assumption is that we also consider that the air is taken as air is used as working substance and it remains gas throughout the entire cycle. Air is used as a working substance, that's why the efficiency calculated is called as air standard efficiency. And another assumption is that the flow is steady. Flow is considered as steady flow. That means we can use SFE equation. That means therefore we can apply or use SFEE equation, because all the elements which are used in this Brayton cycle, like compressor, combustion chamber, turbine, and heat exchanger or cooler, all our devices are open system. That's why we can use SFE equation. So these are some basic assumptions made. We also consider that there is no change in kinetic energy and potential energy. Changes are neglected, and we can also consider or assume that there is no change in specific heat. As the temperature changes, we consider that specific heat remains constant for the working fluid. Okay. Now we can write, as we know that all are open system, so we can apply the SFE equation for all devices, and we know that the efficiency is equal to the W net, that is output divided by heat supply. This is called as thermal efficiency. Okay. W net can be written as W turbine minus W compressor divided by Q supplied. W turbine is the network output at the shaft in the form of rotation, minus WC. WC is the work consumed or work done on the system. The system is compressor. So we can write work done on compressor WC is equal to, letter at 0.1 enthalpy is H1 and at 0.2 enthalpy is H2, and the work supplied is H2 minus H1. H2 minus H1 is the work supply to the compressor. We can also write this expression in terms of specific heats. As we know that for ideal gas delta H is equal to mCp delta T dT. Okay, for unit mass H is equal to Cp T2 minus T1. This is the work done supplied to the compressor. This is compressor in 2 to 3. Another process is in the combustion chamber. So in the combustion chamber there is a supply of heat. So heat supplied in combustion chamber QS, heat supplied QS is equal to H3 minus H2. We can also write this enthalpy, specific enthalpy in terms of temperature, a specific heat Cp of T3 minus T2. T3 and T2 are the temperatures at the respective states. Okay. Next device is 3 to 4 is turbine. So at the turbine there is a work output. We get the work output. So work done by the turbine is WT is equal to, we can write H3 minus H4. This is the expansion of gas is equal to Cp of T3 minus T4. Okay. So next process is heat rejection. So we can write heat rejected per cycle is QR is equal to heat rejected at point 4. Enthalpy is higher, H4 minus H1. After heat rejection, temperature is decreased at point 1. Cp of T4 minus T1. Okay. Write the thermal efficiency of this Brayton cycle is equal to turbine work. Turbine work is W2. Cp of T3 minus T4 minus compressor work. Compressor work is Cp of T2 minus T1 divided by heat supplied. Heat supplied is Cp of T3 minus T2. You can rearrange this expression and you can write T3 minus T2 minus T4 minus T1 divided by T3 minus T2. Further simplify, this can be written as 1 minus T4 minus T1 divided by T3 minus T2. Okay, so we can write 1 minus, you can take T1 as common from the numerator, T4 by T1 minus 1 divided by, you can take T2 is common from the denominator, and T3 by T2 minus 1. Okay, now that this is equation number 1, and now you can use this isentropy process for process 1 to 2. We know that 1 to 2 process is isentropic process, entropy remains constant, therefore we can write this process follows the reversible adiabatic law. So we can write T2 by T1 is equal to P2 by P1 to the power gamma minus 1 divided by gamma minus 1 divided by gamma. This expression we can write for the reversible adiabatic between the process 1 to 2. Okay, and this P2 by P1, this P2 by P1 is called as RP. RP is the pressure ratio. this rp is called as pressure ratio. This is the p2 by p1. Okay, so we can further write this expression as rp to the power gamma minus 1 divided by gamma. Let this is equation number 2. Okay, similarly we can use again 3 to 4 is the isentropic expansion process. Let me write for process T2 4. Okay, so T3 by T4 is equal to P3 by P4 to the power gamma minus 1 divided by gamma is of equal to the RP to the power gamma minus 1 divided by gamma. This is equation number 3. Okay, P3 by P4 we can write RP again, because P2 equal to P3 and P1 equal to P4. From the graph you can see P2 equal to P3. This is a constant pressure line, P2 equal to P3, and at this line P1 equal to P4 is equal to constant. These two lines are diverging lines and these lines are constant pressure lines. Okay, so we can again write here P3 by P4. P2 is P3, P2 equal to P3 and P4 equal to P1. That's why it's again RP. Okay, now put these two values in the equation. Here we can write 1 minus T1 by T2, T1 in bracket T4 by T1. So we can write from these two relations T2 by T1 is equal to T3 by T4. So we can write T4 by T1 is equal to T4 by T1 is equal to T3 by T2. Okay, this relation we can use here in this relation. So we can see here directly this is T4 by T1 minus 1 divided by T2. This T3 by T2 can be written as T4 by T1 minus 1. This becomes cancelled, and further you can write 1 minus 1 upon T2 by T1. Okay, so thermal efficiency is written as 1 minus 1 divided by, so T2 by T1, we know that T2 by T1 is equal to RP to the power gamma minus 1 divided by gamma. So we can write RP to the power gamma minus 1 divided by gamma. This is the thermal efficiency for Brayton cycle. Okay, here we can conclude one thing, that as RP increases, as RP, that is pressure ratio increases, then as RP increases, then 1 upon RP to the power gamma minus 1 over gamma is decreases. This increases, then 1 upon is decreases, and we subtract this value from 1. That's why this 1 minus something is increases. Finally, we can say therefore thermal efficiency is increases. So the conclusion is this: as RP increases, thermal efficiency also increases. This is the calculation or expression for, standard expression for the thermal efficiency of the Brayton cycle.